So what's up, guys? It's another Tools Friday series with FIXITGEARWARE-SECURITY. And today we bring you another tool that's going to help red teamers, offensive security experts, bug bounty hunters, and penetration testers alike in carrying out their various recon process. So today's video is going to be a short one. We don't want to waste much time because we have a lot working on and there's a lot going on, which it's really not what we expected that it was going to turn out, but lots of projects and incoming projects as well we have. So we'll try our best to make this short as possible. And hopefully by the end of today's series, you'll be able to learn something new and add it to your recon process. So without further ado, let's get started. So on today's Tools Friday, we'll be talking about a tool known as BlackWidow. BlackWidow is a web spidering tool written in Python by Zerodex, who is also the founder of Sniper Security. This tool is an awesome tool and has the Injectx parser, which enables you, the penetration tester, to conduct a quick lookup on various OWASP's top 10 vulnerabilities on dynamic domains of the target which you're trying to pen test or hunt for bugs. So while this tool is designed for penetration testers, we believe this tool can also be used by forensic investigators as well if they intend to investigate a domain that belongs to a malicious hacker, as this tool has the capability of crawling the entire website and getting more information about the domain that is specified by the person in terms of the offensive security expert as well, or the forensic investigator using this tool. As we all know, when it comes to websites or domains, we know big organizations have a lot of softwares they interact with and they're using their various businesses, right? So these softwares most times are integrated into their web applications as an anchor. So those anchor links are links that would redirect to specific pages or platform services that this organization use in performing their day-to-day service provision to their various clients. So if you're into forensic investigation, you should also take your time and look out for this tool. And of course, try and see how you can use it when you're conducting a forensic investigation or, you know, researching about a malicious domain that is in your scope of investigation. So for this tool, the key features this tool can perform, as rightfully stated from their GitHub repository, is that it automatically collects all URLs from the specified target. It also collects dynamic URLs and parameters from a target website. So if this domain you supplied has anchor links or dynamic URLs embedded in various code of the website or the web page, it's going to crawl it and, of course, retrieve those domain names and show you in the terminal or save it as well in a text file. It also has the capability of retrieving subdomains and collect phone numbers if there are phone numbers on the website, and also retrieve email addresses from the target website if there are email addresses. It also collects the URL that belongs to the organization itself, which are also embedded in that same website. So not just subdomains or anchor links, but also other URLs as well that belongs to the organization. Might be a link to internal organization resources or admin panels. This tool will be able to crawl it and get those informations. It also has the capabilities of parsing for OWASP vulnerabilities, as we rightfully stated previously, and, you know, check if the dynamic domains that was retrieved while crawling the website is vulnerable to any of the OWASP's top 10, and as well indicate to you, the penetration tester, its findings while trying to inject using the fuzzer tool to detect those vulnerabilities in that dynamic domain links that is being recon. So all these data are saved as text files, and of course it will indicate it, the location where these data are stored, And you can, from there, as the penetration tester, navigate to those directories and, you know, cut the files and check the informations as well. So this is the command on how you can use the tool. And we took our time to draft this for you that is interested in using this tool, because there is no much detailed documentation on the website. However, these definitions are what was stated on the website on the various commands. So we took our time to retrieve this and, you know, put it in a good format and in a clear format for you that is interested in using this tool. And also how to install this tool. These commands are also listed here in this presentation. We also took our time to do this for you. So we wouldn't be demonstrating this installation because we've already done it. And actually it's complicated, as there are no detailed information about this on their website. But based on our own ends, after researching and executing these commands, we came up with this. And of course, with these commands, you will be able to run this tool and install it effectively on your Kali Linux machines. So if you're going to use this tool, I advise you to just follow this instruction from the sudo apt update and all that down to the sudo install.sh to get the tool running on your Kali Linux, running on your VirtualBox machine. So that being said, let's navigate to our VirtualBox machine and demonstrate this tool. Previously, when we cloned the GitHub repository, we had the BlackWidow on our desktop. So when you git clone the repository on your desktop, this is the BlackWidow. So it's in capital letter B and capital letter W. So when you try to cd to run the command which we described below, you have to specify it the same way the repository was defined. So it's gonna be like this. Okay, so however, I will not be doing this. Then secondly, once it's done, you do not need to be in the repository anymore to run the tool. So for us right now, we want to test two domains for you to see how the tool works. The first domain we are going to test is our own domain, which is fixitgearware.com. We do not have any anchor links or any information there. So you wouldn't find any information that will be discovered from fixitgearware.com. And for the second one, we are going to try McDonald's, where you can now see how this tool works and be able to crawl this McDonald's and retrieve information about the McDonald's franchise website. So to do this, we'll say BlackWidow. Okay. Then we'll say minus u. HTTPS, our website. Okay. Then we specify level, we say 3. Now you can see it says this. Now the reason why we're having this is because we did not use the sudo command. Okay. So when you're running this, ensure you use the sudo command. So you come here, say sudo, then you run this. Now, as you can see, we do not have that error anymore, right? So these are just a series of the escape sequence the tool is running. And over here, you wouldn't see any information because we do not have anything related to anchor links or subdomains on our website. And some more, there are some security measures we implemented on our website. So you wouldn't be able to crawl the website that much to get information. Unlike big organizations, they do not need to implement excessive securities, as they require their users to, you know, right click, open link in new tabs and all that. On our own side, we implemented certain securities that do not allow those right clicking and all that. So this tool will not be able to crawl much information about our website. Now, let's say we want to crawl for McDonald's. So we can come here and we can say McDonald's. And if we hit enter right now, you can see right now we're having information, right? And this tool is very fast. Within a twinkle of an eye, everything will be retrieved about the website or the target domain which you have provided. So we previously ran this, but we want you to experience the feel of how this is done and how fast this tool works. in doing this live recon. So the essence of this is very good for you, especially if you're very good in hunting for various vulnerabilities, right? Not everything you need to run SubFinder or Nuclei and all those other tools, because everybody's almost doing the same thing. So you can actually log in into a target website. Let's say you create, like you register an account, right? Then once you register an account, you just retrieve that link and put it over here in BlackWidow to crawl that domain link supplied. So once BlackWidow has the access to that link, it's going to crawl everything, including in the admin panel or the dashboard of the user or administrative dashboard, and get all information related to that target. Okay. So from there, you can now take those domain to be able to see the ones you can test for command injections, SQL injections, LDAP, or any other forms of vulnerability. You have an idea on how to, check for those endpoints and test for those vulnerabilities. Okay. So over here, you can see these are all valid domains. If we see this right now, there's what we call classification by category. So for each here, you can see it tells us for this domain, look at what it crawled. So you can pick any of this. Now, once you go through these links, you can understand the ones you need to check out for and what you should look out for in those ones you want to check out for. And if you come down here, you can see something. Sorry about that. If you come down here, you would see both for forms. If there are locations where there are forms, it's going to pick it up and tell you. So you as a pen tester who is good in testing for SQL injection, you can focus on that. Like here, you can see these are form URLs discovered, right? And you can see it tells us location, contact information. So I can pick this right now and of course test for SQL injection if I desire to pen test this target. Okay. And over here, you can see the dynamic parameters discovered, right? So this is like mail to contact information, location, and all that. So we can pick this as well and, encode certain, and add certain positions. And of course, test for SQL injection parameters or even XSS, which is cross-site scripting. And also on the same website, you can see the whole email addresses that is found on the website was crawled and of course displayed back to us. Finally, the most important thing about this is that you can always go back to this link here. Once you seed into this directory right now, you'll be able to find information about this whole process that has been conducted. So you can, assess each files. And of course, retrieve any information you want to retrieve about the recon that was just conducted. And of course, further perform your penetration testing activities. One more thing I also want to share with you. Sometimes you might have issues of, not able to get this BlackWidow part, okay? Which is in the user share BlackWidow, right? So you can just come here and say sudo mkdir minus p for parts, then you say user and you say share, then you say BlackWidow, okay, and you close the path like this and you hit enter. So in essence, what we're saying is that we have created this path. So whenever we use the BlackWidow tool, it's going to go to this path and save our loot, which is of course it will name the loot with the target domain name or information, so we're able to understand the information that we want to sort, because once you're pen testing various organizations, right, you would not have only one target, you have multiple targets, right? So this will be saved here in this BlackWidow directory, and of course by the name of the target you recon. So there's more to this tool. I wouldn't be going deep into this, but as a security expert or forensic investigator or security researcher, think outside the box. Understand there's something we're trying to communicate here to you. So just find a way to think outside the box for yourself and find a way to implement this tool. So one more thing also I want to share with you is that over here, you can see here, this is minus C for cookie. Then of course, if you understand how to retrieve cookie and cookie value in Bobsuit or any pen testing tool you're using, you know that right here will be the cookie name and of course the cookie value. And this will crawl the target with the information provided. So this aspect of the crawling is very important when you are authenticated, right? And you want this BlackWidow to crawl the dashboard. Of course, you need to supply the cookie value of the authenticated user, right? So you can always put this here. And I wouldn't go deep also. You should know how to retrieve this information as well. Think outside the box. There's something we're trying to communicate here regarding that. And with that, that's all for this tool. It's a very good tool. Use this tool only for good purposes. And if there are any irresponsible acts that this tool was used to conduct, then FIXITGEARWARE-SECURITY will not be held responsible for that. So with that, we have come to an end of this week's episode, and we hope you've learned something new. If you find this video interesting, please do not hesitate to give us a like by hitting that thumbs up button. Subscribe by hitting that subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you'll be the first to get notified when next we post another video on Tools Friday series with FIXITGEARWARE-SECURITY. Thanks for watching and see you next week. Bye for now.